Ladies and gentlemen, the Super Bowl 46 champions, the New York Giants. Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States, accompanied by Coach Tom Coughlin.
Hello, everybody. Everybody, please have a seat. Welcome to the White House, and congratulations to the Super Bowl champion, New York Giants. We've got some members of Congress, members of my administration who are here today and rabid Giants fans. I want to also recognize the Maras and the Tishes, as well as, of course, head coach Tom Coughlin and general manager Jerry Reese. They have built this team into one of the NFL's most outstanding franchises, so we are very proud of them. I know for some of you, this is just welcome back. You guys have been through this drill before. The last time the Giants were here was in 2008. A lot of folks thought that team didn't have a chance to win a Super Bowl. They ended up winning with a circus catch in the fourth quarter. MVP performance by Eli Manning. A come-from-behind win over the Patriots. This is all starting to sound kind of like deja vu all over again. But every season is different, and last year's Giants were obviously a special bunch. Not just because of where they ended up, but because of how they got there. Every team has to deal with injuries to the players. Not many teams have to deal with a late hit on the head coach. You saw that Jets game. Now, Coach Coughlin reminds everybody he did not go down. You know, that's a tough guy. And you can see that toughness reflected in everybody else on this team. The Giants took a whole bunch of hits this season, but they never went down. From day one, they followed a simple motto, finish. Finish the play, finish the game, finish the season. So I would just advise the sports writers out there, the next time Eli says he thinks he's an elite quarterback, you might just want to be quiet. Again, I want to congratulate the New York Giants. Good luck this season. Looks like we've got somebody singing for you. That's how happy everybody is. Give the New York Giants a big round of applause.
Thank you, Mr. President. On behalf of the New York Giant organization, we are honored to be with you today. I just want to mention a couple of things that the president, although he covered pretty much everything that I wanted to say. Following the Canyon Heroes Parade, and following our return that same afternoon to MetLife Stadium and a reception of 40,000 people, we began to focus on the inspiration that this football team, the New York Giants, presented to all Americans. To those who perhaps were down on their luck, whether it be because of an employment issue, the economy, whatever, how this team might have inspired them to hope, to believe in themselves, to never give up, to strive to accomplish their goals, no matter how difficult their situation might be. But however, as many people as we have touched along the way, the real inspiration for our country are the men and women in the military, those who protect us and our freedom every day. They allow us to play the great game that we love on Sundays. They allow us to live freely in the greatest country in the history of the world, the United States of America. And the real heroes, as the President has said, General Odierno, Colonel Greg Gadsden, and the wounded warriors that are with us here today. So another applause if you're here today. Each group having different objectives and motives, but playing in harmony for each other, for the good of everyone. Wouldn't it be nice if Congress operated the same way? I stand before you today and present the Super Bowl 46 champions and the world champion, New York Giants. Thank you. At the end of our team meeting the night before the Super Bowl, this was our final thought. Maybe what matters most is not only how we reach the finish line and why, but who crosses the finish line with us. We cross that line together as one, and that's the reason that this team is world champions. A few short years ago, I said that I hoped that this experience today was not a once-in-a-lifetime experience. Now I'm saying I hope, Mr. President, it's not a twice-in-a-lifetime experience. We both have a goal to get back here next year. We have a lot of work to do, so let's bring these captains up here and get at it.
I knew you had to run out of second.